social living, to me, it was kind of identity I can like put my art behind. It kind of comes from like social interactions or just like talking with friends or strangers or just like weird things I see or hear like just out in the world. I don't know, me and my friends always been creating something, whether it's been like videos or random designs, and try to take it a little more serious and see what I could do. I guess the propaganda style is like kind of prominent in a lot of my work. I was kind of always intrigued, fascinated by like how certain artwork or information or like propaganda posters could influence people to take action. They were influence wars, influence peace, influence how people perceive things just by a design, something they see on the street, a sign, a poster, something like that. So I kind of always wanted to incorporate that feeling or that style of propaganda art into my work and into my messaging. Literally, like, all my pieces come from like old magazines, old school books like National Geographics, like Essence, Time, Life, Saturday Evening Post, a whole bunch of old magazines and shit that don't even get produced anymore. True, you can't get the same kind of textures, same colors, the same like fade or like vintage distress like look from digital. It's like, for me, it's kind of easing, like just a calming process in my art where I'm looking for different source images, or I'm going to a thrift store looking for a certain book, or you know, going to state sales, breaking into buildings, whatever you got to do to get the source images. I think there's definitely something unique and something different about using kind of printed material instead of just Google searching or stock photos, stuff like that. I was working at a print shop 2017, around there or so, and was doing like a lot of design work and just like different printing and stuff in there. And then from that, I kind of was doing my own printing on the side and like kind of figuring out how I kind of wanted to produce and like make more of my own art. And in between that, I got a space at Red Fishbowl in like 2018. But I still do stuff there regularly. A very, very cool place for a lot of different and wild art. Been doing like events with Red Fishbowl before their studio space. And then when they did that in 2018, one of the first artists that was spaced there with them. And I think after that, just doing festivals, and then 2020, I had my first solo show, November into December. And then 2021, I applied for this, the Brewhouse residency, and luckily got in, and been here since, and been trying to produce art. Got a lot of goals, a lot of things I'm thinking about, trying to keep experimenting with like the medium of my work, from sculpture to installation, digital pieces, analog, collage, combination, all that. I definitely want to just keep experimenting. We have an exhibit coming up at the end of March for the whole Brewhouse cohort. So all the artists in the residency will have a decent amount of pieces in the exhibit, and it's I can already tell it's gonna be pretty dope and unique, and it's a wild group of artists here, so definitely don't want to miss it. March 31st, I'm pretty sure it's the opening. So working on a lot of stuff for that. Besides that, I want to do, I got a couple ideas and plans for some public art and some more wheat paste mural art throughout the city. If you have a space or you're looking for some custom large scale public art, hit me up. And then coming up, I also have a lot of new artistic apparel, and a few more lifestyle goods for my brand, social living stuff. I definitely want to do a project with a couple of my digital artworks where I'll be doing selling the original NFT and the original working file of some of my digital pieces, and I'll be donating most of the money to charity, a couple local nonprofits as well. So that'll be coming up in a couple months, and I'm excited for that because I'll be able to offer a lot of my digital pieces as the original and owning the working Adobe file or whatever it may be, all the layers. You can find me at social.living on Instagram or socialliving.us, whatever you want to call it. That's the website. You can definitely check out all the art there. Got some dope clothing and some lifestyle goods, all that stuff you need to live a happy and full life.